some, do some YouTube videos and anyone else. If you ever do YouTube videos and you take a break after a couple of YouTube videos, you stop taking that. Anyway, this is a woman sitting on my robot, Marvin. And I like that picture because this is a woman in a cat suit, which was last year at Google Maker Faire. And this thing underneath her is my robot, and she's actually steering it with the remote control. And actually, Marvin, which is also here present, is the reason why I started developing the Arduino Eclipse plugin. Basically, I had an Arduino, and I was programming it, and I wanted to make a real robot, and it just didn't work with the Arduino U. So I said, why not in Eclipse? So, and the Arduino Eclipse plugin has been renamed to Slug.
Say it again.
Slug. That's Dutch. And it means something like naughty boy. It's a long fight with trademark issues and stuff like that. Anyway, the agenda is just so how to download Slug. So for one single person who did not do his homework. And I'm going to show you who we are, I mean the core team of the plugin development. We're going to ask you some questions, already did, we'll ask you more. So then we actually, what was the wait while the copy was doing stuff like that, we're going to unpack at StarSlugger. Then we'll have some history, then we have some question and answers, and then we're going to play. That is the reason, that's the bulk of the discussion today, and then we have wrap up. So, download the plugin. If anyone tried with Chrome and didn't work, it doesn't work. Sorry, I forgot to mention that in the mail. We all did this, so maybe I should turn this around. Did anyone have some experience that he said, this didn't work, this wasn't fine, this was weird? No? Great. Good work on us. So people in Windows have to also 7-zip, but we all did that. Good. So, we come to who are we? Now the core team currently exists of me, William Youngman, and Roberto. So we have 66% of the core team here. So that's me, right, Jeff? And the thing I'm holding here is Marvin when his drive engine is broke, so I could push him in my garden. So the background is my garden. And, oh, I didn't even notice that scene. Sruber is actually my cat. And we were in the middle of discussions about trademarks and stuff like that with Eclipse and Marino and Google. And we had to find the name, and my cat died. And my cat also featured in some of my YouTube videos as the evil creature. So we actually decided to go for Slug, which stands for Software Library for Open Embedded Board Development, Eclipse, Repository or something like that. That's an abbreviation. Anyway, this is me. I'm a nerd. I'm also super papa, as my daughter, so I can be honored. It's an honorable title, I think. I'm also a moderator of the Dutch part of the Arduino Forum. Not really relevant for people here, but there are Dutch people here. I'm also the developer, designer, architect of Slugger, and yeah, I'm now sick leave home for 3 years, but I'm actually an IBM employee, so that's why I actually started with the Arduino, just to get people on board about it. Mr. Roberto, I leave this to you.
Okay, Roberto Giacco. I'm the author of the Natural Plugin for Eclipse, plugin for behavior-driven development. I'm a geek, and I'm a maker. I'm an open source enthusiast, software architect for free, employee of RC Bank and services for money, and contributor to Slugger.
Slugger.
Yeah. No problem.
You got to introduce him, or do I do that?
As you wish. Name is Nebula Project Lead. Ever heard of the Nebula Project? call additions, UI additions to Eclipse.
Yeah. The scope. How is scope is in Nebula?
Based on the Nebula oscilloscope.
Yeah.
Yeah. Actually, ours is a plotter one.
Yeah, I know. I know.
Okay.
That's my bad.
He is a maker, and he has kids, so maker also little humans. He is the CTO of Remain Software, big company in and he is an active Slober developer.
Slober!
Developer and contributor also.
Wim is actually one who made the project and all these very nice Eclipse integrations. Most of that one is Wim's work. Okay. Some questions for you guys. Who has worked with Eclipse as an IDE?
Everybody, yeah.
Yeah, everybody? I think I was one. Who has not?
you are cheating. You raised your hand twice.
Both answers are correct. According to what you said, so yes, you have no question. I also work with something that is not Eclipse.
Okay. Okay. The question is badly stated. Okay. Who has never used Eclipse?
No, it's basically Eclipse as an ID. The ID is a plugin in Eclipse.
I don't have used Eclipse for other things, like our IDE.
That doesn't count. It's as an IDE. So you have not used Eclipse as an IDE. You have not really gone the other development or you
Yes.
Okay. Current first question. Who has worked with CDT?
We're lucky, man.
Yeah, we're lucky. Because this workshop will go flying. Okay, so who has not worked with CDT?
Okay.
We have your focus pointers here. So who has worked with the Arduino EDE already? Oh, why are you doing here? You already know everything. Oh, so I assume the rest didn't?
Did you notice that a couple of people that did use Arduino IDE never used Eclipse CDT?
I didn't, Who has already used the Arduino Eclipse speaker?
Never heard of it.
Okay. So who knows C++? Okay. I think you're the correct people. Yeah, really, really, really. This is the kind of public we had in the back of our minds when we were thinking who would be joining me. So we'll quickly switch to that because we already did this. Have you been able to copy it now?
Yes.
Have you been able to open it?
You should
execute something like Slooper EDE, but it's on a Mac. I don't know. Is it up?
Yeah, it's working. Yeah, you just have to
click
it first.
Okay.
And then you download stuff.
Excuse me?
Yeah, but the download is going to be...
Do you have it already? I cannot download it.
No. Oh, you didn't do your homework. You cheated.
Because I was not registered to this session.
But that's not a problem. But you Windows, Linux?
Yes, Windows.
Windows? There's a folder Slooper, and there's a subfolder Windows. There's a folder Slooper. There is, in this folder Slooper, there is a tar file. You have 7-zip on your system?
Yes.
Okay. You need to untar and unpack. So that's the only one you can keep the stick. So you have to unpack and untar the Windows 64 or 32-bit version as you wish. Should be in the Slooper folder. It's in the Slooper folder you have to be.
Windows 7 64.
Yeah, but I mean there is a 64-bit tar file and a 32-bit tar file. There's Win 32 okay. And can you help him getting?
Yes.
You know how to do it on Windows.
Sure. I have a question. When you just talked about don't use Chrome to do it, how does it apply? Because we use an IDE, and we also need a
No, the problem is if you download with Chrome, People reported that the download always fails. That's just a problem. It was something I forgot to mention today. But the download with Chrome seems to be unreliable. That's all. Nothing more, nothing less. Yeah, but you're on a Mac, so there's probably something. And I think it's also related to firewalls, which are somewhere in between. And just if we get reports of people saying, I can't download, then we ask, are you using Chrome? We mostly get yes. And then we tell, OK, use something else, and then it works. OK. Arduino. So some of you know Arduino. It actually started as an open source and open hardware project around the AVR chip. But it evolved, and actually currently it's actually a very pretty open community, and there is lots of hardware currently supported. Yeah? So this is an ARM processor, the ESP is also, I'm not a hardware specialist, but where Arduino actually came from, very focused Arduino Uno and the Arduino board made by the Arduino people and lookalikes or deviations. Arduino now is actually more a community, and the Arduino EDA is pretty open, and you can actually plug in any compiler underneath it, as long as it's GCC, and compile for any hardware or any software, any hardware you want. Yeah? For instance, one of the things I have been doing is compiling my Arduino code as a so-called port on my local system, so I can debug my code. Yeah, so I can step through the code and see what's going wrong if things go wrong. So it's moved from, I want to express that because lots of people think, oh, Arduino, it's only Arduino boards. That's about gone for a year now, I think. Yeah. With version 1.5, that changed, and 1.5 never was released except for in betas, and since 1.6, Arduino actually kind of like describe a format and in text files, and if you can interpret those text files, you actually can compile any GCC compiler for any type. Yeah? And this thing, what the Arduino EDE does, is exactly what the plugin does, and it feeds this information in CVT, so that CVT actually does the compilation and the whole thing. And the plugin is basically a connector between the Arduino files and CVT. Yeah? Arduino also still, has not changed, focuses very much on the beginner level. So I personally, if you're starting with new people in the Arduino world, I would say start with the Arduino EDE, workshop class with somebody who knows what you're doing is also good, but if you do it on your own, I say start with the Arduino EDE, because they made it so simple to do it, and it's so easy to do it, but if you're used to using Eclipse, you'll very quickly say, this isn't good enough anymore. And Arduino, which I implied by saying it's CDT, Arduino code is C++. Yeah, you know the Eno file format, it looks like C++, actually it is C++. Arduino just does some preprocessing. So, this is your starting point, normally if you start with Arduino, but there's actually no official from Arduino grow path. There's lots of other tools based on makefiles and other stuff to compile serious projects. But Arduino does not give any directions and you should do that, or should do that, and not for hardware, not for software. Yeah? But anyone who has been used to developing has very quickly, when they understand, what took me some time, when I understood, hey, this is actually C++ I'm programming, I actually quickly wanted to get rid of this. We're talking 2011, so that's a long time ago. So there's no refactoring, no call trees, no library development version, no version control. Well, they're adding some stuff here, but their main focus is beginners only, and therefore they're they're limiting the possibilities because they don't want to add features because they're annoying for beginners. Every button which is added is a big discussion inside this Arduino, whether they want to add a button because it's going to be confusing for the developer. Yeah? And I think they're taking the right decision on that behalf, but yeah, that leaves possibilities for an Arduino CDT with an Arduino, like Eclipse CDT with an Arduino source. I think that's yours already, isn't it?
Yes. Yeah, I got. Yeah, I got.
Yeah, but the Eclipse CDT with an Arduino source, I think that's your words as well.
Yeah, no, I was saying the icon is the new thing that
the
we are.
The icon is the new icon of the plugin. So you should see that in the bottom of your screen. Yeah. Because we had another icon, but that was not good for trademark as well. If you can avoid discussions with legal. What does the plugin do? It supports creation of projects. We'll do that. Well, it knows the toolchain based on the Arduino info, is that what I'm saying? Well, actually, link the toolchain based on the Arduino information. You can upload, we have a serial monitor. We also have a scope, which is actually a plotter. But we have used the scope of Nebula as a plotter. That's just me not knowing the difference when we have discussions. And there's also easy integration of libraries, and we support .eno files. Not as good as Arduino, but my take on Eno files is as follows. I am a long-lasting C++ developer. I don't really like those Eno files, and actually in the beginning I actually refused to add functionality for Eno files. But later on I started developing libraries, and with libraries you want to have examples, and those examples are going to be compiled in Arduino, so I actually had to add support for Eno files, because otherwise you could develop the source code but not the examples in the plugin. So it was kind of like annoying. And then I found a really good idea how to do it, and because I found a really good idea to do it easily, it actually supports 90-95%. But there is some slide that it should show the differences between the two. But the plugin can do far more. Anything which is in Eclipse, of course, is immediately taken away. Everything which is in CDT, you use it. And the product is the best way to get started, because then you have everything in one go without having the difficulties. You can install it as a plugin in your environment if you have a special version control system or whatever. I do it because I use JAS as version control. It's also very open, because it's the source code. Even the website is in the GitHub repository. It gets updated and then nicely built. If you use to change the website from the GitHub to the next day, everything is updated on the website. And there's also Travis CI integration, so if you would pull request, I can see whether it's fine or not fine, and so on and so on. So it's, yeah, we've got nothing to hide.
Yeah. Not yet.
Not yet, yeah. Well, I have had some discussions because, yeah, you know, money is tight for everybody, and so not many people want to contribute and stuff like that. But it's difficult to combine open with something which is you have to pay for. I haven't found a good way yet. I've tried several things. I've tried, if you use a plugin after a couple of builds, a window pops up, and I try to put there, what do you want to be developed? And then you could support something with it. But it didn't work. Problem, I think, is that we use this thing ourselves. So if something is not working fine, we probably already developed it long before you could think about it. That should be missing. I have nearly all our reinforcer. So yeah. And sometimes people, sometimes I get the board simply because somebody has board. Hey, it doesn't work with that board. Ah, I didn't know. Because can I send you one? Then you can test it. I mean, you have to. Anyway, the history. So I started in 2011. In those days with Trump. Yeah, it was Trump, I think, yeah. But Trump all of a sudden had something else to do, and he was something focused on when he came back. I came back to say hi and suddenly I was gone again. So I was actually pretty soon all on my own. And then I developed 101 based on the WinRPF plugin. Okay, some people may know the WinRPF plugin. And so there was only Windows. That was the days I was working on Windows. I didn't have any machine in those days. And it was actually fully CDT oriented. And what I mean by that is, for each Arduino project, you have two projects in Eclipse. One to make your core, build your core library, the core folders, because they get bundled in the library. And then your sketch was dependent on the other project and linked in the library that way. Yeah. That's basically how it worked. It was completely RPF bundled, so you had to fill in lots of folders. It was the days, yeah, when we were still, we were happy working in Eclipse, and now we were a bit more dependent on the money. You had already your sketch. As you see here, I still parsed the boards files. I don't do that anymore. I haven't, the plugin hardly has any knowledge of how those board files are built and what's in there. I try to limit that as much as possible. But the top part still pretty much looks like how it is today. And as you can see here, you have the two projects. So you have here the project where you compile your board, and here you have your project where your sketches. And you also see typical C++ myInclude, which is not visible in not ino files, because Arduino has that behind it. And then we are 2013 V2. It's a big step forward because I dropped WinRVR. We completely configured based on Arduino IDE, which means you only have to have the Arduino IDE. And the sketch project also contains the core, so the two projects merged together. And support for TNC was added, which was actually also the reason why you had to need to use the debug one, because TNC uses defines, which also changed your core. Yeah. So still the same view here. Oh, did I go wrong there? Yeah. So here we have add libraries, which is still available. We have an auto library include now, but you can manually add libraries, and sometimes you have to do so. Now you see that there is these same things are completely changed. There's no more blocking part. Also, this is the menu items you see in the Arduino menu are here. In your project properties on your Arduino. And we also added compile options, which is the basic differentiation between the Arduino IDE and this one. You can change the compile options, or at least you can add compile options to what Arduino is telling you what compile options are, which I mostly use for defines, as you can see. I have my own query. Extensive way of programming to define stuff like that, I use communicator to switch on and off parts of code. So that's, if you use that, you're incompatible with Arduino IDE because Arduino IDE does not support defines or import programming. Everybody still asleep? Still awake?
I mean, question I'm talking to. Don't worry about if you are not getting something about this. History of the, yeah. The plugin. We are just going through different evolutions.
How it changed. Yeah. So these are the, so here you see that now we only specify instead of all those folders when you have to be there's a GCC compiler stuff like that. There you only specify there's the Arduino IDE, and that's the a huge difference for configuration. And we also added the scope. So the scope is an easy way. We do make an example about the scope. For instance, if you have a sensor and you want to know how far it is, if you just see numbers scrolling, that's not easy. But if you see a line going up and down, it's lots easier to follow. Sixth channel. So 2016, we're this year, and actually this year we're very proud to announce we have version 3. Yeah, it's only a couple of months out. The 1st of April, we released it. And actually, since the 1st of April, we've been discussing about legal issues. We hope it's over now. But We actually even cut now the link to Arduino IDE. You do not specify the Arduino IDE anymore because Arduino implemented the board manager, and we implemented the board manager in the plugin. And so we download all the boards ourselves and we manage it. So there's no link anymore with the Arduino IDE, which basically means that now you can just start the thing, it configures itself, and you can start compiling, which is a huge, because how easy you make it, if somebody has to configure somewhere, they'll probably do something wrong, and you'll get tickets, and you lose time, and not fun. So we have the boards and library manager integrated, and another great thing is we have the automatic library include, because another thing is, I've included the library, and I have imported the library, that's not what they tell you, but the code doesn't apply, they say, and then you have to ask the console output, and then you get error output. So automatic library includes another big change. So if we compare the Arduino IDE with Zubin, you can see that there's lots of green smileys with the Arduino IDE. I'm pretty happy with the thing for a starter. Yeah. But the thing where it's actually where it's not so good is syntax highlighting, refactoring. I put yellow there because I'm used to refactoring of the GDT engine, and CDT refactoring is not as good as the GDT refactoring. So if you're used to Java refactoring, this refactoring will not be as good. It's also possible to debug now, and data and the create libraries is something you just can't do. Yeah.
And why don't you have the other?
Because I just never implemented it.
Okay, because there's more online tools from apps and code that you can use.
Yeah. The thing is, Arduino has, I have to be political here. Arduino defines everything in files. To do things, you have to read those files. Typically, you also have to get some inside knowledge from Arduino how they do things. Let's say they could define it better in the file, but they're not open to discussions in that level. I don't know why. But, running the bootloaders is just something completely separate, where you again need to read something from the file. I just added support for programmers, which is in IT, which is there, but it's not in the official release. It's kind of like, why did I add?
So it's really depending on the information from Arduino, basically.
It's basically depending on who has time and effort and energy and is willing to implement it.
Yeah.
And I actually hardly do bootloads programming. So as I can just, maybe that's probably going to change now because you have to have Arduino installed. Until April, you had to have Arduino installed, so it was just starting Arduino and do it. But now you will have to install Arduino, and so probably there's going to be a request sooner or later, and then we'll see how. It's just a matter of you haven't done it, the Greek codes yet. So what we did do with version 3, and that's, I think, a serious thing, single install. As I said, you just install and it works. Auto library include, it parses your code using the CDT parser, it parses your code, searches for all the includes which it doesn't find, searches in your includes tree, and every include it finds there, it will include in your code. Which means it's actually better than what Arduino IDE currently has. Yeah? I don't know much better. I don't want to put emotions there. The auto open serial monitor connection is another really cool feature. Basically, again, using the CDT indexer, I search the serial begin, and I see what's your serial rate, and I know where you uploaded your code to, so I know your COM port, I know your serial rate, so you can just click the button, and you're open the serial monitor with the correct baud rate. Yeah? So these are productivity tools. There's plenty of visual improvements.
I did my part.
You did your part. The ENO files are actually now no longer part of the CDT build. They're now actually part of the actually Eclipse build. So there is a builder to build ENO files, which is a great improvement because that means that you've got ENO files. The ENO files are actually processed immediately and they're not processed during the build. And that also means that the indexer is behaving better. The indexer is also part of the build. The CDT step is not always executed. So if you're working, you have to have continuous build on, but you're not continuous building because the CDT build is only built. But the indexer is complex. You can also save your scope data. I've forgotten about that. So scope data can be saved to text files, so you can parse it with Excel and that. And there's multiple boards. Support, multiple board versions. You can have Arduino 1.6 and 1.7 in the same workspace. And you have version control. That's the multiple board. There's so much changing. Okay. And now your action. It's up to you. So it's like so to do. It's basically what you want, you have to do. So I want you to open the plugin. Who already has the plugin open? Everybody who has the plugin not yet open?
You don't have the...
you haven't done your homework. You have the plugin open?
Yes.
Yes, okay. So we're gonna make a sketch.
I think I don't have it open yet. As you see, I have lots of Arduino versions here. And I also have a Snoopy. That's how you open it.
This is the brand new logo, so if you... I think we fixed that Sunday evening or Saturday evening. Don't know why on Linux it changes this weird code.
It does that on Mac too.
It does that on Mac too?
Yeah.
There's only one bitmap in there. So I don't know why. Probably. I did this morning. So anyway, here is the button for new sketch. So that's what we're going to click. And then you have to type a project name. You can type whatever you want. Oops, I'm not allowed to do that because I already have a group. So then you type next. And here, so the board.txt, this is a big difference between Arduino IDE and it's here. Your action in Arduino IDE, you work with names. I actually work with the board.txt files. Because you select the board.txt files, and you can see here, there's a version number. I can support multiple versions. Here's the version number. Yeah. Don't be scared. I'll open mine. I have zillions of board.txts. Yeah.
Okay, sorry, we don't have this first line now.
If you don't have that first line, that's because that's you only have all the board.txts. If you just did not install any boards, you only have one board.txt file, and it's purely normal that you have that. Yeah? So then you call the Arduino Uno or something like that. That's just to hide a bit.
Unnecessary.
Yeah, to hide a bit. So if there's none, but you should still see in the second line, you should still see the boards. Yeah? That's because you have the ADR 161 board of TXT Uno. So you pick your, we call it the Uno, the Uno here. You put the port, you don't have to do, so as you see here, this is, as I said, the protocol I implemented. This is pretty new. And here you can select a default ENO or CPP file, custom template, some body stuff file implemented. I don't even know whether it still works. I always use sample sketch of before the default ENO. So we like I said, we are going to do G for this here. We are going to create a blink but we're going to use the blink without delay. If you have lots of libraries, then you have here lots of. I'm already pushing fast. In that thing is the product, and there is also a folder, the download thing. And so what you should do is after you install the project, you should copy the download of your system in the download files, and you should copy the JSON files in the Arduino plugin folder.
If you copy the wrong
thing.
Make sure.
Okay, the one I got.
Yeah. And the weird thing is that you have ESP. Are you sure you were having this format view or things not ESP? There's no Windows now. What is it over there?
Do they publish on GitHub those files? Are
those are files they're not ours. Anyone who wants to create a
No, but is admin publishing on GitHub?
I don't think so.
We are accessing Arduino.com.
Yeah.
And then we are opening up with
Arduino.com. That's possible, I don't know. I don't care what's in the core file, it just contains, it's even a JSON file. Is a JSON file contain a link to somewhere a zip you have to compress and contain instructions out to compress it, and I don't care. If the JSON file contains all the instructions to download and unpack, and the board for TXT and platform for TXT file then contain all the information you need to run the commands, and basically, I don't care. The JSON file says you have to get that zip file, which is full of viruses. Well, yeah.
We have infected your computer.
He has infected your computer.
No, I mean, seriously, it's the same like Arduino eWorks. It's also why Arduino, the link we will see, is also called the unofficial support boards. It's basically anyone can create the JSON file and point to anywhere. That's part of being open. So, anyone found the blink without delay way? Note that if you select here, there's a number of selected examples.
Yeah, that's the here, the output BMP file.
You can select multiple examples.
If you have a
this can be handy if you know, for example, you want to base it on that example and that example and that example. You can all select them at once.
So
the project will compile, okay? You can have all your source code to kind of base.
We don't do delays.
Huh?
We are programmers. We hate delay.
Yeah.
He's got his first trainer now.
So that's one of the nice advantages of Eclipse.
So,
and while you have an editor,
there's another one
here, which is for debugging.
Yeah.
And that's the old way.
So the
and then he creates the
morning session,
the project.
So yeah, there's nothing has been edited and changed here. As you can see, that's the.
I don't know how you can see them in.
That's the great advantage of Eclipse. You see, you can
hover over it
and see the code. So if we go here to begin the pin mode, we are actually now in the core files delivered with Arduino, and you can just change them. Yeah. So I advise you use version control for everything. You can be in Arduino code and not be aware of it and change things, which you cannot do in the Arduino code. Yeah? Do you understand what I'm saying?
Okay. So, but people who know CDT, they know that there's, you can, so for instance, here output is a macro, let pin has been defined somewhere here, and yeah. All the CDT things are here.
Yeah.
So, and if you click this button, already you will probably get a dialog box already answered that one, saying, do you want to build before upload? Yes, no, always. That's a very late addition, but you can select never and always. This option about never and always, you can change here in the preferences Arduino. Here, build before upload, yes, no, ask the upload. And also the function to open serial connections and automatic input libraries you can place in here. That's, so the upload, so the console window is your best friend, I think. I like problems and the problems view and the RPOs, I like them, but my best friend in CPT is still the console window where you get all the outputs from the compiler output, because then you see the sequence, which is mostly very important. So as you can see, he failed to upload on my system and on yours probably as well. Unless you have an Uno and you have a patch it. Is it 40?
Yeah.
Huh? Okay. Everybody's happy? Everybody failed to upload?
Okay, we started.
I didn't fail.
Okay, can we launch it?
Launch it?
We can't run. Or can we run?
You can't compile. You have this button here, which is simply compile, and this is upload, just like in your Arduino IDE. So if you click the V, it will compile.
Okay.
If you click the arrow to next, he will upload and he will ask you first whether you want to compile or not and whether you want to remember and stuff like that. Did you fail to upload?
He's uploading.
He's uploading?
Thank you.
Do you need me?
Words.txt.
I'm an artist, I know. So everybody failed to upload now? Anyone have an Uno who succeeded in uploading?
Right.
Huh?
Okay.
Who succeeded in uploading?
Yes. I think I'll do it.
Yeah, you can see it's only in your Arduino respond lights. There's a LED blinking, and you can change the delay times, and then you can see whether it's delayed longer. That's the problem. You change the delay times, and then you can see whether it's actually changing the. You don't have the words.
No,
very simple, add Arduino, include Arduino.h at the top of your file. And if somebody of CDT is here, which can give me a hint how I can avoid that, I would be very willing to listen on how I can fix that. Are you from CDT?
Actually, I used to work for AppleCorp,
yeah.
And I wrote Savior for this video.
So okay.
I can give you some hints.
Yes. Okay. There's a full documentation about what the problem is, so you probably can pinpoint if you can do this or that.
It's been a year, a few years, but that was right. We can talk
about
yeah.
Okay,
no
so
pressure.
No pressure. No, I can live with it. I don't have a problem with it because I personally say, the thing is, the reason why you have this problem is because you don't have any includes in your Eno file. Public I'm focusing on is not beginner, so I'm not focusing on people who do not have an include in their Eno file because that's not a project you're doing with their Eno. So basically it's not really an issue, but people get started and they see the red line and they panic and they say, oh, something is wrong. Basically it's nothing wrong.
I am one of those.
I'm not one of them because I started with just having to have C++ files. Yeah? It's just a workaround for the Eno that you see. Yeah? So, we have done this. We have built the sketch method and installed the boards. Okay. So, has everybody now been able to install the board he has with him? Anyone who has not? Yeah? I gave somebody an ESP board, yeah? You have been able to install it? It's still ongoing, yeah. Okay. You're lucky that all the rest start on it, because everybody is on Wi-Fi, it wouldn't have worked.
But it's not finished.
Well, it may work. Okay, so what have we learned from this exercise? Yeah. So if we look at this project again, you actually see here core. Yeah. We see here core, and in core that's actually the Arduino delivered libraries. Everything which is in core here is what makes actually Arduino. Yeah? These are source files which describe the API, pin mode, and digital write, and stuff like that. All that stuff is in core. Yeah? We have here in the root our source files. Yeah? And believe it or not, your configuration is called release, and that's why you have a file here called release. And in release, is actually all the compilation output. Yeah. So if you don't find your stuff, then it means that somewhere here, that in the viewer, you don't show them. See, I have your checkbox and start files, which is normally not there.
V1.
You V1? Okay. We're a team, man. So, as you can see now, this is in one project. That is this one of the V2 improvements, and all your core files are there. If you look closely, you see here this special thingy for people not used to Eclipse GUI. This means that it's a link. That means that everything which is below that is also a link. So that means that if you change those files, you change those files for everybody on your system.
Did I see somebody who had a question?
You need your bathroom. I can't help you. Run! Run! You're used to running now today. So the variant, that's something from typically Arduino. It's actually the file which is in here is actually your specification of your board. This file contains the match between pin numbers and A3 and O4, which are printable boards. Yeah?
Actually, Ian, here you might help me.
Yeah.
It doesn't have the drivers, the Arduino drivers installed.
You don't have Arduino drivers installed.
So it doesn't recognize the Arduino as a COM port. Do we have the drivers on any of our pen drives?
Yeah, if you make a copy of your Arduino folder, because
the ESP, the same problem here with the ESP driver. Do you have an ESP driver? Maybe not for the Mac.
The ESP driver for the Mac, that we do not have, no.
Actually, it doesn't need the drivers.
Yeah.
Windows.
Mac.
You
don't know about Mac.
Do you want to kick me?
No. Yes. There is a folder, Roberto.
Yes.
There is a folder drivers in the Arduino folder. Take USB key. Go to Windows machine. It's an Uno, so the drive should be on there. And which Windows is it? XP?
7.
Oh, 7, yeah.
Looks like 7.
Yeah. In Windows 10, they're included.
anybody?
Yes.
You do have Windows, right?
Yes.
And you do have Arduino
ID. This is not
okay.
Any other communicating?
No, we just need the drivers.
Okay, sure.
So, see, it's on the learn curve. It's on the learn curve.
Why there are errors, then it compiles fine.
It's something weird, something that happens sometimes, it doesn't happen, but I'll explain what it is all about. So, the console view, as I told you, the console view is your friend. For people who do not know a CDT, you can also do another thing. People who install from the marketplace, not the product, there is an Arduino perspective. So you should be on Arduino perspective. Normally the CDT perspective is practically the same. This doesn't make any difference. So you can show you the CDT problem details. Is it this one? No, that's not. You have here problems. So the problems gives you a summary of what is errors on your or warnings, but it's all your projects together. Yeah. An interesting view. Yeah. The tasks view. I personally like the tasks view very, very, very much. I don't know. Does everybody here know the tasks view? Yeah. Everybody. Who doesn't? Yeah, that's the to-dos. So it if you just type in your code somewhere a to-do, he will parse it and you can just find it. I personally like that very much because you're doing something, you have to do something else. Oh, I haven't finished, but I don't want to focus on the other one. Just write to-do and you can find that. Yeah.
I don't know why, but I use it mostly for fix.
Yeah, fix me. You can add any key, by the way. You can add keys if you have special keys. But that's all Eclipse. I mean, it's a bit, what the bit difficult thing for me is, if everybody here would know CDT, we could just focus on the Arduino port part, but I have a bit. Huh?
I didn't say, I didn't know CDT, but I know KDT, so it's more.
Yeah, this is the Eclipse part. This is the Eclipse EDE part. So it's in GDT, it's CDT, it's in all. Yeah? But the problem, I think, is CDT. I'm not sure, but I think the problem is CDT. And the console definitely is CDT. Can't you see now?
No, not that one.
No?
No.
I have never seen the console. I never used the console when I do Java development.
Actually, I think that console is in platform and not in case. So it's common for everyone who wants to use it.
Yeah? But you don't often use it when you do Java development. Do you?
No, no, we do.
I never thought it. I've never used it. Anyway, see? There's lots for me to learn as well.
So,
we have seen hover, autocomplete, about the refactor, I read for the refactoring, already said that. It's not as powerful in CDT as it is in Java. Yeah? Definitely the autofix, which I really like in Java. I would love it if somebody would do that for me. I need to CDT as well so that you. If it says it should be int, that you can say change to int or something like that. But that's not there. Yeah.
It's really hard.
It says option change variable to int. Selecting change to int would be.
Refactoring is harder.
It's harder. I fully agree. Definitely when you start using defines, and I love defines.
Yeah.
I'm being gay.
A little bit. But remember, you are on tape. So, it will stay very easy.
Anyway, and the usage tree is something I really, really, really like. But as a small example, it's very hard to give it an example, but you can right-click and say open call hierarchy, and then you immediately see where it is being used. And it's one of the things which I think is a big difference between Arduino EDE, because it allows you to think about if I change that, where am I impact and stuff like that. Yeah. That's also in GDT. So, that was what we learned about the first exercise. Is everybody still following?
Almost.
You've installed the drivers for the Uno? Huh?
Kind of. It doesn't see the port.
Yeah, that's the maybe you should try a more standard Arduino than
really
ESP.
Set the properties on the project.
pretty happy that we got to the top one.
Yeah, I got one suggested by default. So, and we have the same No, this is actually very different. So I haven't used any, I haven't put anything for a few months, but I remember it very
well. And you have
a? This is a new.
Yeah, which one green do you have?
I haven't, no, but it's a maker green, so it's a slightly different.
That's exactly. Yeah. For the
Marcos. Doesn't have a comfort for.
I don't think it has this
detective,
but it run message from the console and you can maybe see when it's
since those are brand new. What if we try
anomaly?
No, I've been giving you my euros. Have a zero and he's trying a Leonardo for the control pattern.
Leonardo Sharbot has no other.
You should be able to. No, it's seriously different from Guard's point of view.
I know, it's different. It's at a level.
Leonardo
Sharbot. Usually they get it.
Yeah. Does he find the Leonardo?
Yeah.
The Leonardo is found, okay, then you can use...
Try, if it doesn't recognize that, try this one.
Otherwise, you can try the unit, which is actually Leonardo. Leonardo seems to be found.
The unit?
The unit is a Leonardo. Not sure that's the... Oh, no, there's no boot on that anymore. we boot on
space.
Who burns butchers?
Oh, LSB.
Are you ready to go to the next exercise? Hello? Are we ready to go to the next exercise? Okay. So the next exercise, what we're actually going to do is we're going to include SPI.h in our source code. That's to activate the auto build. Yeah. Auto library include. Yeah. So what we do here is in our blink without delay.
Sorry, but I don't have any other
problems. I have a zero, which is
even worse. It should be even worse. We can try.
Yeah. We can try. So if you do here include, so it's a good example of when I press control space, it shows you lists of the variables, and you can if you do include SPI.h and it is save, then there should appear a new folder in the root, which is libraries. And this is which contains a link to SPI. And so the libraries folder, that's the auto discovery. The SPI has been found. I could not auto complete it because it was not yet in the project. Now should be able to complete SPI.h. And it's fully automatically added because of the indexer. If you look in the error things, you will see warning that he found SPI.h and he doesn't know that one, and then he included this. Now, what's important about this SPI.h, if we look at the properties resource, you actually see that this SPI is part of the AVR. So if we go to, for instance, a TeamC or a whatever work we're not going to do because there's too many problems with downloading and installing boards. But if I would go to a TeamC, this AVR would change, the SPI.h library would be a completely new library. And if you have two configurations for a project, you can have one for the TeamC and one for the AVR. And if you swap configuration, it will automatically change the link for you. Yeah? It's very important that you're aware of this. There's a concept in Arduino which is hardware libraries and no hardware libraries. The hardware libraries are actually libraries that have to change when you change boards. Yeah. Whereas the other libraries are good for all boards. These kind of libraries. The bridge library you can use for all. It depends on the resources that are available. But the switch happens automatically. Yeah. I can demonstrate that on my PC because as you can see, I have plenty of things. Anyway, so we're going to add a build configuration now, and I will take a completely other, which you guys just pick, for instance, the Mega or something like that. So here you have the manage configurations, so you can create a new one. I'll create ESP. Okay, and I set this one active. Okay, so now here in ESP, I can change. Now I have to look here in this huge list of things to do the ESP. So, I'll create a new configuration. As you can see, I created a new configuration. I made it active. And as you can see now, it's ESP 8266. Yeah? You see it? Change the SPI, and that's why you should never ever put anything in the library's path, because basically the library folder in your root is and the core folder are owned by the plugin, and if you start messing around there, you'll probably get into problems sooner or later. Yeah? And you can so if you should now have your own configuration, and you should be able to build this for another board. Have you not created a new configuration? You right click on the project. Yeah, there was many multiple boards in there. You can do it for the Mega. You could, for instance, now have Uno and do it, create a new configuration for the Mega. Yeah? So you right click on the project, and then you have properties. Yeah? And on the properties, you click Arduino. Yeah. And on Arduino, you have here Manage Configurations. Yeah. Then you can create a new configuration and put another board, for instance, the Mega. And then you have two configurations. Yeah?
This is really, really useful when you work with multiple boards.
You have one project for all the boards.
And you can also upload much faster to the different boards, different configurations.
You still have to see
each
and configuration.
Yeah.
But the build is maintained,
huh?
Right? Each
you don't need to rebuild.
each configuration will maintain its
own. Because there is a root folder. So as we had just, you see here we have release and ESP. Yeah. In the root, there is release and ESP. See?
Yeah.
Here's the stuff of release and here's the stuff from ESP. So it's just a different folder where everything is kept. So it keeps everything there. We will not do rebuilds all the time. And you can right click, say the build configuration button. You can say here make build. Yeah, you can also do build all and then you will build all. Yeah?
Oh, yeah.
And another thing I use this for is, for instance, if you, I sometimes modify Arduino libraries, main core files, and when there is a new version, you can just create a new configuration with the new Arduino version and check whether everything is fine without having to. Yeah, without having, you can have just the two, one for Arduino 1.0 and one for Arduino 1.5 in the same projects, just two configurations. Yeah. So it's handy.
Do you still need the hardware or
not?
Huh? Do you still need the hardware?
No, no, no. You have Arduino ED, there used to be a time when you had Arduino EDEs and you had Arduino EDE versions. Yeah. Arduino EDE versions have disappeared because we're no longer pointing to Arduino EDEs. So in your case, with the Arduino Eclipse plugin, we pointed to an Arduino EDE. If you wanted to upgrade, you actually had to move a very important point of the first part, and everything now pointed to something different, and you had to create multiple workspaces, or you had to work in one Arduino EDE version. Yeah? Now, Arduino EDE version no longer really exists because Arduino EDE started with using a boards manager. Yeah? So that means that every board now kind of like has its own version. So you have, for instance, ESP version 2.1, but you also have ESP version 2.2. Yeah? Both of them can exist in the plugin together, and you can compile for 2.1 and 2.2 kind of like at the same time. Yeah? So the version number moved from Arduino EDE to board version.
So my question was, if you want to compile, just to see if your code compiles for different boards, do you stick me before physically or not?
No, you
can just switch and test if you compile.
That's what we did in the first exercise. Mm-hmm. You compiled for Arduino and you didn't know whether you had Arduino.
Yeah. Obviously, you cannot.
And then the upload failed. But that's how people. But people tell me it doesn't work. As long as it's the compilation that fails, I can easily test it. If the upload fails, then I can't test it if I don't have the hardware. Yeah? So if the upload from a board fails, I'm probably more likely to get the hardware than if the compiler fails. And so you can have multiple versions, and as I showed you, the hardware dependent thingies just swap from one end to the other end. Yeah. So. Now everybody should have done at least one upload. Have you succeeded in doing one upload?
No.
Leonardo did it
once. There's a problem with pin mode.
There's
one there of the pin mode problem. But it's not the same problem. I mean, we added an input.
Problems, but you also have
this is a good way to obtain a map. You need the hardware to solve the problem. It's an open, it's an open source project.
The SPI was changing, but also the core folders are fully automatically changing here. So if you look here, the core, I'm currently in ESP mode, I think. Properties, so indeed this is ESP, I'm in build configuration ESP, so everything in the core points to ESP. When I change this to, which you can by the way see here, there is something wrong with this declaration that it doesn't always update. So if we set active, go to release. Now the core folders, that's why he's hovering. We're now back to the ADR ones. So the core folders and the hardware libraries and libraries are automatically switching as needed. Yeah? So, that's actually what, there's a lot of people who say, oh yeah, you know, I set up my own project in Eclipse and stuff like that. This is stuff you don't have when you set it up yourself. You need code behind there, which can interpret stuff and do that for you. Yeah? So the libraries are switching automatically. There's a build folder for each configuration. And so the configuration can be different in nearly all aspects except for the code base, of course. But for the code base, there is still the exclude from build, which is, I think, a CDP feature. Not sure. But if you right-click on a file, on a source file, not on a
are you looking for? Configurations, it's resource configurations built from that. For one reason or another, he does not do that for flexible CDC.
I think
we
need to extend the handler to actually add your INO pipeline.
It's INO is just C plus, it's identified as a standard C plus plus file. We'll come to that later, but yeah. I changed the configuration and said dot INO file is a C2P file, so I would expect it to work.
They could be different handlers.
Yeah. Mm. Anyway, for we don't want to exclude INO files from builds anyway, so it's not a major issue. But standard CPP files, not header files because they're not picked up by the compiler anyway. You can select exclude from build, and then you can select the configurations where it should be excluded from the build. Okay? It's something very rare. It's just the only exception to the rule of the source code is the same. All the configurations, all the other configurations can be. So you can have other compile options, you can have other defines and stuff like that. Yeah? So, up to the next example. And now I'm going to let you do this all on your own. Yeah? This is your to-do. This is a workshop. You need to work. Please create a new sketch for your hardware based on the example. Read the ASCII string. Can you do that? If you need help, you can raise your hand.
I was just curious about the
for example, if it's a memory well, so I had a question for me on my
Yeah, but there is some of it. your pocket is.
Or just restart the document. There is somewhere where you have a version with the
document.
I think for the user, very frustrating to find out there is two versions and they have been working with one version and then there are another version. That was my very first concern immediately. I can tell you, I got issues from this project, legal issues from my I think it is an issue from a commercial or a support point of view. I think it is an issue.
You have to be
sure
of with marketing. This is not the only Arduino CPU. It depends how you put things together. If it doesn't, and then you know the difference. Basically, all you need is to support the manual build system. You have C++.
There is more work if you want to support Arduino. It's quite a bit of work to be done. The moment I found the way to do it, the whole Indo file was one file in my whole project. And I shared like 100. So that was actually, and now it's included in the build.
Builder, those will be on the C file.
Should be, yes.
Set the new line at the end here. Here is your monitor. There is here at the end, and you need to set it to new line. Okay, it was new line. And otherwise, the program will not work and will not respond to you what you have set. Yeah? But if you set it to new line, it should work. And then you get the response. Now, what's important about the serial monitor, in contrast to the Arduino IDE, the serial monitor supports 6 channels. So in the same view, you get 6. You can have 6 connections to 6 Arduinos, and each Arduino gets each connection gets a different color. And because it's Eclipse, you change your colors in the preferences. You type color here, and here you have Arduino, and here you can change the scope colors if you don't like it in the same amount. And they change on the fly because somebody just bought it.
That's really useful when you want to make some communication between boards. You can monitor the 2 boards at the same time in the same screen.
So if the only impact you have is that one serial connection may have sensed up a bit faster, so it may have happened to the time before the other one arrives. But basically, you can see this Arduino says A and this Arduino says B, and because of the coloring differences, you can see which one comes, and you have a timeline as well. Whereas if it's 2 different monitors, you completely lose time. Yeah. They appear in the same thing in a different color, in the same. You can test it. Just nick the board to the other one and plug it in and connect to the serial monitors and work. You can see it. Yeah. It's very handy. I've seen somebody who posted on the internet, I think it was a certain Roberto, which a picture of 4 different colors for his communication.
It was the very first time that he had seen the multi-serial connection working.
No, the first time I saw that somebody was using it except for me. It's not really the same thing. So we did that. Yeah. So as to what we should have learned here, if you can connect multiple boards at the same time. You can upload to multiple boards. I have run tests with 10 Arduinos at the same time. That's mostly because I want to test with several types of Arduinos, so I connect all the types of Arduinos I have. I have a big USB switch and I plug in all the, and then I just test and run and upload quickly. So and they all can. So you have 6 channels on the serial monitor. So the open, so the standard you do with the plus, and then you have to select the COM port, and it's time consuming. The plus is, so the open serial monitor, the direct open, is a very thing. You still need this one, X, to close your connection. Your connection you close is the connection which is visible here in the combo box. So here you can select the combo box, you send to which one you want to send the message, and you also to which one you want to close. And the auto scroll features now look nice. They used to be ugly icons, now it's nice icons, more compliant to how the Eclipse works. The reset, you can reset your boards, but not all boards that will work to reset. It depends on whether it's board struggling or port and stuff like that. There's also things green and dot dot because of the bitmap. It's a font issue. What is important here is that if you have a program, you connect with the serial monitor, and you upload a new program, the serial monitor will reconnect. Note that it will reconnect with the baud gate it was connected. So if you have your program, you change the baud gate, you upload, then the serial connection will not work as you expected. So there is no
looking back at the board frame at reconnect after uploads. Yeah? And there's multiple different colors. So, yeah, the plotter example, we had a bit of a networking issue. So the plotter example, the somebody in the back has downloaded it by now, I hope.
It sometimes happens, I know.
Okay.
Not your fault. Do you need the library? Yeah. Do you need the library? Download the library.
Yeah, well, I don't know whether we really need the library. We just can, basically, you know, the library is handled for the best library.
This is going to be needed by everyone, everybody, right? No, it's the keyboard which is really weird.
Oh, but that's nothing. I'm used to it. I used to work typing quickly with a
certain. So, there is a Wi-Fi share, and you should be able to connect to a Wi-Fi called, what's the device name? There is a Wi-Fi shard
Eminent.
It's for free. And then you can connect to 10.10.1.1.
I don't see it.
Connect to that, Wi-Fi, then open 10.10.1.1 in a browser. So HTTP 10.10. Show you how to install the library. We are going to use a library, Synplot, which is the library used for in Arduino to communicate with the plotter we have in the plugin, in Slurber. I'm sorry, man, I cannot pronounce it correctly.
Yeah. That doesn't matter.
Is there any way to get this file? Because there are some steps that are passed.
Yes.
Oh dear, have you copied the disk? Have you copied
not
the SD? Have you copied everything which was on the SD? The presentation is on the
just
SD.
Just copying what we are telling me to.
Everything on that on the on that
the
USB
on the,
is
on
for
the stick, if you just take a stick, the presentation is on there.
So that's not this?
Yes, it's the same. And basically it's on the here
so
as well. No, it's here on here as well, right?
Yeah.
In the stupid folder.
Oh, okay.
It must be a wait a while because it's gonna be slow now. So because I cannot download the whole thing in one go. I created a folder simple in my libraries thingy here. The Arduino, your personal map, Arduino libraries simple. Also for an example. It's two very, very short, not fast, but unfortunately it's going to be slow.
Is it dying?
I'm not sure it's dead yet, but
you can refresh if you want.
No, don't.
Are we all connected at the same time? Yes.
I feel we are.
It's a €20 device, lads. Don't put
it
at this risk.
Can I say it's Italian high tech?
No, it's actually Korean high tech.
Oh, Korean high tech. Okay. No, just I think I'm gonna get a stick by this. So there's, if you have the library copied.
Didn't download?
It's actually on GitHub.
Yes.
If we had a good network connection, I would have told you to import with GitHub version control the libraries to your system, those immediately, and then you have them in your project, the libraries, and then you can still add those libraries for that folder as a private library folder, and then you can immediately see the library. Do you understand what I mean?
You ask me.
I don't think there's many candidates who understand it. And on the Slooper, there is a folder presentations, or the presentation is on the
Okay.
There is so much data because I have all the download packages on there. But not for Mac, because I don't have Mac. I feel some kind of repetition here. You just need to copy the simple now to your libraries folder in Arduino.
So if I'm on Windows, is the documents folder
the user documents folder. I don't know in macOS.
The story in your personal folder are videos. Yeah, well, out of Arduinos. You know, this one costs €1.50 or something like that. Believe it or not. €1.50. Just go to AliExpress. Don't order more than one because you'll pay more.
What?
AliExpress. You look for Node MCU ESP and you'll find this one. And if you look for the price, cheap ones, you'll see €1.50. This one costs €1.50. Not worth stealing. And it contains Wi-Fi in the whole lot. It's a Node MCU 1.0. I didn't believe it myself. Somebody told me. I tried them. I bought two, and they seem to work. So I'm happy with them. We're here. So now I have the Simplot here, and I will use the buffer example.
The Simplot library is used by the Arduino to communicate with the plotter, which is into the Eclipse plugin.
So basically, this is the command which is in the library, which is sending data. So what it does here is a couple of sinuses for, and in the library, there is defined Simplot 4, Simplot 1, Simplot 2, Simplot 6, and it just takes another list of arguments. And the only thing it does is it packages in a binary thing and sends it over to the other side with binary markers. This is the beginning, this is the end. Yeah? And it doesn't do more than that, but together with the plotter in the plugin. So this is the line. I also print them, but this is just pure for so you can see the difference between how it scrolls over your serial monitor and you don't know what's going on. And in the plot you can see there's nice sinuses going on. Let's see. And this is the only line which is important for the plotter. It takes a serial, which of course has to be open. And stuff like that.
So
everybody has found the Simplot library by now?
So the library, then you should put it right inside the Arduino libraries folder.
Yeah.
So this is Simplot. Arduino library Simplot.
Arduino library Simplot, yes.
So I have the Arduino library in the
But we create a new MC project?
Yeah.
Yes. We are going to create one.
It's just easier for I considered making an example which grew, but I had this impression that this idea that from my experiences from workshops that there's always somebody who's getting behind and then they have to get up, and I think it's just easier to make. I think you're all smart enough to know you can combine these things.
Oops. Watch out.
Sounds like Mother Nature tells me they're not.
Oh, I can hear now as well. So this is a default in your file or default in the file? This is not sample sketch?
If you have imported the library, you can use the sample sketch.
I don't know.
we finished the first example.
Have you seen auto working?
Documents folder.
You have to upload it to your Arduino and then open the plotter and see whether you can see something. I am still trying to get this to work for one reason or another. I'm just having too many hardwares here on my system, and yeah, I'm getting confused. As you can see, this is not a good way to work with so much hardware. But I had to install all this hardware, so I had download files so I could make disks. So probably I just should go here.
Okay. If you go to the server, right click on the project, properties, okay, cancel, Windows.
Those are leftovers. We have to replace two items. That's for debugging. If you have a device for A, B, and price, but we can't. Yes. And that's the.
So you can just put.
audio?
This one, you want this one, the one that was in there. It's this one.
Basically, that's the standard import source code, but with again a bit of source around it. I think we're at the end of this is in that understanding. Don't know whether anything. Whether do you want me to explain this, or do you say it's enough? I go home.
What's the difference
between
the Pino and
the PD file? No, don't get me started. You want to go home?
Well, PDE is the old file extension.
Yeah.
That's INA is the new file extension.
Exactly.
That's a good answer.
Yeah. Oh, there's one slide I definitely have to show you. Please give me a plus. Give us a plus one.
Any questions, folks?
You should go
ahead.
If there is any questions, you can always try GitHub.
You know it's 56 degrees in here and that we need a beer.
Yeah. No, I'm waking up. I'm waking up.
Because I mentioned it.
Unit.
I don't think people
But you should not see why it will also look
like this.
But you can find them for 30 euros, and you can find them for $1
or something like that.
So the IO custom.
Yes,
IO custom field.
Yes,
so cheaper.
The motor, the solar panels for energy.
Shooting the whole day.